Let's pray. Lord, tonight, we just take time to acknowledge you. Lord, we take time to worship you, praise you as our Lord and our Saviour. We thank you that, Jesus, you came to earth quite willingly for us so that we have the opportunity to spend eternity in heaven with you and God. We just thank you so much for that. Lord, as we offer up our praises and our worship tonight, and in such a society where it's so busy and its focus isn't on you, we focus on you. Will you help us to focus on you? Holy Spirit, come, settle on us. Just be with us tonight, Lord, and feel honored, feel praised by us. In Jesus' name we ask. Amen. Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared, with the angels praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests." Well, that's us. His favor rests on us. So let's stand together and we're going to sing with the angels. We're going to sing "Hark the Herald Angels Sing."
Long lay the world
If you've got a prayer of thanks, Father, you are just almighty. Now, lift your voice. Say it loud. Let us hear it.
And we know how much Jesus means to us tonight because of what you have done in our lives. Father, we're just saying that Jesus rises with healing in his wings. And we thank you for what you've done in our lives. And we just thank you in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord.
Let's do that chorus again.
Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices, oh, now divine, oh, night when Christ was born.
Lovely to know that some of you are out there in the dark. Great to have you here. I'm just going to change mics. Yes, so tomorrow morning we have our Christmas Day service that starts at 9:30. If you haven't had enough tonight, or you think this is so good I need to drag a neighbour or a friend along, then 9:30 here in the morning. Team, thank you for opening the service. It was a bit of a scramble tonight, but it really came together. So I'm sure you'll enjoy the rest of the service and the singing too. So. Morris, would you come and read the scriptures for us now?
Tonight's reading is from the New International Version, Luke chapter 1, verses 39 to 45. It will be on page 992 in the Bible and pews in front of you. At that time, Mary got ready and hurried to a town in the hill country of Judea, where she entered Zechariah's home and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. In a loud voice she exclaimed, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you will bear. But why am I so favoured that the mother of my Lord should come to me? As soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leapt for joy. Blessed is she who has believed that the Lord would fulfill his promises to her." May God bless the reading of his word tonight.
Mary got ready and hurried to the house of Elizabeth and Zechariah. She'd been there before, most likely. Verse 36 in the same chapter says that Elizabeth was a relative of Mary, possibly an older cousin or an aunt. But as Mary calls out, probably at the doorway, "Hello, Elizabeth, are you home?" the Holy Spirit flashes revelation into Elizabeth's heart. The baby in her womb, who became John, that's right, just making sure you are there, the baby leaps inside her mother's womb. Now, I can only know from what Louisa said, she can tell when the baby kicks. So who knows what a leap would be, but she felt it. Elizabeth, in an instant, recognizes Mary's voice and why she'd come to visit. Mary hadn't emailed or sent a text or in any way warned her that she was coming. Not only did Elizabeth know that Mary was to be a mum, but that she was to be the mother of the Messiah. At that time and culture, girls generally did not get pregnant until they were married. It's a bit different today. And Elizabeth likely knew that Mary was to become Joseph's wife, but they hadn't married yet. That ceremony had not happened. So by the standards of the day, it would have been a major surprise for Mary to be bringing the news that she was with child. Holy Spirit did a wonderful and glorious revelation thing in Elizabeth's heart as soon as Mary came to the door. And here's the gem I want to share with us tonight. We find it in Elizabeth's word to Mary. "How blessed you are, Mary, because you believed the Lord." How blessed you are. "You believed him though he had chosen you. You believed him though what he said was impossible." Whatever the reasons the Lord chose Mary, how blessed she was that she believed him. Now, we may never know all the reasons. That's probably some aspects of that that will be secret between her and Mary for eternity. But the whole world knows now that she responded by believing. That's what probably made the difference. She had this capacity in her to say, "Yes, Lord." Now, what about you and me? What if the Lord called us to something special? Now, the job of being the mother of Jesus has already been taken, but there'll be plenty of other jobs that he'd have in mind for us to do if we're prepared to say yes. But sadly, many are likely to fall at the first hurdle. Oh, he wouldn't choose me. I'm just little old me. See, we shoot ourselves in the foot before we've started because of how we see ourselves. We see our weakness, our failures. We see in our background and in our heritage, blotched by imperfections. We figure, he wouldn't choose me. Why ever would he choose me? I'm figuring Mary was a lovely girl, especially in her nature. She wasn't bitter or hurt. She wasn't carrying the kind of baggage that made her preoccupied with herself and her own wants and needs. She was probably just happy being herself. She didn't think of herself better than anyone else. She was just happy who she was. And when the angel came to speak, she was not prideful that the angel came to speak with her. She didn't think to herself, well, what kept you? You know, I've been here, just the beautiful, loveliest thing on the planet. Where have you been? I've been waiting for you. No. She humbly expressed her surprise, but finished up with, may it be as you have said. Nor was Mary put off by what she could not understand. This will trip the rest of us up. Chances are, if God calls us to anything, there will be an element of impossible with it. That's because he's letting us know that he wants to do something with us and in us. It's not, this is what I'm sending you out to do or be by your own effort. He lets us know these things because he wants us to participate. He wants us to come along with the ride. Don't be intimidated by the impossibility. Both the angel previously and Jesus later taught, all things are possible with God. So many fall into the trap of analyzing the impossibilities to such an extent they undermine the little bit of faith they did have. They figure, oh, that couldn't have been God, because what I thought he said is impossible. What if Mary had got caught up with the impossibility of bearing a child, though still a virgin? Where would we be? If she, no, I can't do this, God, that's impossible. Praise God, she didn't say, this is impossible. May it be to me as you have said. So maybe this Christmas, God will begin speaking to you about something he wants to achieve in you or through you. Please don't start by putting yourself down or reminding him of all your problems. He's letting you know because he loves you anyway and he wants you to cooperate with him. Say, yes, Lord, I'm believing you. What would this world be like if his people said, yes, Lord? And don't carry on by pointing out that what he's proposing will be difficult or even impossible. Don't even go there. He's God, you know. He's God. And he's telling you about what he wants to do because he wants you to enjoy the ride. His work in your life will be part of his plan to show others what can be achieved when someone believes in him. What he does in your life and mine will be like a light. It'll be a pointer, a sign. This is what I can do in the one who says, yes, Lord, I believe you. Don't let him down. If you were to give Jesus a present this Christmas, you could start with a, yes, Lord, I believe you. I'll do what you say because I'm walking with you. Amen. Now we're going to be treated again with some more music, and when you can, sing in.
Kay's just going to sing this one as a an item. So if you just sit there and just reflect on that. Mary didn't have the answers. She still said yes. Mary, did you know that your baby boy one day walk on water? Maybe did you know your baby boy save our sons and daughters? Did you know your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you've delivered did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Maybe did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? Kiss the face of your baby, you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know that your baby boy rules the nation? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? The sleeping child you're holding is the grave. Together, let's stand and give thanks with our grateful hearts.
give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given. Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given. Jesus Christ, His Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Because of what the Lord has done for us. And now let the weak say, strong. Let the poor say, I am rich because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks.
Shall we sing it again?
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Because of what the Lord has done for us. And now let the weak say, I am rich because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks. Give thanks. Give thanks.
Oh, just give your thanks aloud. acknowledge that you do sit on the throne. That you are our God. You are the King. And one day every knee will bow and every tongue will confess. You are so glorious. We thank you for loving us. We thank you for giving us the gifts that you give us. We thank you for the things that you do in our lives. We pray for our families, Lord. We pray for our friends as we come together over this holiday time, Lord, that we will be the strong ones, not the weak ones, and we will proclaim you. We will show them that you love them too. Oh, Lord, may it be a blessed time. Go before each one of us, Lord. Go before each one of us. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. See, praise Jesus.
Okay. I can't actually see you, so I don't know what you're doing. We're going to do this, O Come All You Faithful. So we've got, you know, the girls and the guys. The girls are going to do the first, O Come Let Us Adore Him. And then the guys will do the second one. And then we'll all come in really triumphant. O Come, Let Us Adore Him in the last one, shall we? Okay. All right, away we go.
Oh, come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come let us adore him.
Oh, come, let us adore him.
Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. True God, light of light eternal, Lord, he abhors not the come let us adore him, Christ.
Lord, we just pray you bless everybody here tonight. Father, may they go tomorrow and just celebrate your birthday with joy, with you in their minds and their hearts. We just thank you, Lord, that you are with us. In Jesus' name, amen.